In this lesson, we're going to make a start on the job creation with workflows. And the first thing we need to do is design the pop-up. So let's jump in and make a start with that. Before we do that, I just want to tidy up this table slightly to make more room, more horizontal space for the job title, which will be dynamic. But a lot of these other ones, yes, they'll be dynamic, but the width is predictable because they come from an option set. So on applied, for example, if you double click on column E on applied, head over to the layout tab, and let's try a fixed width of 100. Yeah, 100 looks fine. On posted, let's try 200 fixed width. Far too much, 160. And what are we doing is just making sure that the text element can grow a little bit more than it currently is at. We'd want this to be in maybe the triple figures, but also we've got that this text up here needs to be have similar padding on both sides. Okay, so this is just sort of guesswork slightly, but we have visual feedback in the design, fixed width in this guy. Let's try 180, too much. Let's try 140. That's better. So room for another zero in there. Location, let's try 140 on this as well. Probably need more space than that. Let's go to 150. And I think that should cover most of the location names. And then term, this is a predictable one. Let's try 120. Yeah, that looks good because we only have two values here, full-time, part-time. And then that opens up some more space here, some more width, okay? That's better. So, the job pop-up design. We're going to choose a pop-up, click once, drop it on the page. This will be called job. J-O-B, it's going to be a column container. We're going to make the width 576. It's a creative choice, but I've already built this and I know that that width works quite well. Obviously, we could change it later on. Let's change all the padding to 32. Okay, make sure you have a border style set of borders with 12 roundness. And we're going to create a new style once you've done that. Call this pop-up large. And create. Fantastic. Now we're going to set a type of content here. It's going to be called a job, okay? And we're setting a type of content because we will be creating a job shortly in this pop-up. But later on, we need functionality for a user to be able to manage this job as well, such as editing the job or deleting the job, or even viewing more data about the job. And for that purpose, we need to set the type of content job because we're going to be pushing data from a repeating group into the pop-up, okay? Let's grab a text element next. Let's drop it in. Let's say create job. And this will dynamically change to edit job later on. Let me choose a heading 6. And I'm going to center align that. I'm going to remove the min width and the min height. And I am going to fit width to content, okay, for a very specific reason. And I'm going to center align that. So we need to now position an X here to run a workflow to close this pop-up. So grab yourself a material icon and just drop it into the pop-up. Search for clothes, then the second icon should be the X we're looking for. Change it to the charcoal color. Over on the layout tab, let's make it 24 by 24. Now, we're currently in a column layout, so I could put this in the center and I can move it along this axis. I want it to the right-hand side on the same row as create job. So for that, we're going to use align to parent. So I'm going to highlight create a job, highlight holding down shift, the X, then right-click, group elements in an align to parent container. Okay, this group now needs to be named header. And remove fit width to content, remove the min width, and remove the min height. Now find your X, it's probably in the center, and move it to the right-hand side. And your create job, yep, any of these will do, top, center, or bottom. We have the group, the height closed right down. Okay, I prefer just to always put in the center, and then that will be on the right-hand side. Okay, but I'm after a subtitle as well. Always put subtitles. Just a nice, neat design pattern. Let's say, create your job below. And let's align that in the center. On the layout tab, let's remove the min width and the min height. And now, with that new text highlighted, also highlight the group above, okay? The group header, right click, group elements in a column container, and then apply some gap spacing on the layout tab of 12. Maybe that's too much, 8. Okay, now this actually becomes the group header. So let me just fix this up. So that is the group header. If I open group header in the elements tree, I can see the one beneath that, which is the create a job with the X. And for that, we'll just call that title. Okay, so we have the pop-up, then the group header, then the group title. Perfect, looking good. I'm just going to take you to the demo app just to show you the behavior of this pop-up. So here's the demo app. Okay, we've just created this up here. And now we have some summary text on the left, and on the right we have description. These are both text elements. I want these to be clickable because when summary is highlighted, we're going to have a bunch of inputs and drop-downs. And then when description is highlighted, we're going to have a nice big text area where a user can write a job description. Okay, so I thought that would be better within its own tab. So that's what we're going to do next, and we're going to use states for this. So grab a text element, drop in the page, let's say summary. On the layout tab, remove the min width. And let's make the height 40. Let's head back to the appearance tab. I want this to look a bit like a button, which we can actually do with the text element. So I'm going to center align this. I'm also going to center the text vertically. I'm going to check that box. Looking good. Now I'm going to add some roundness of 8. Background style, I'm going to set to flat color, and I'm just going to use my default primary contrast. Okay, with that done, I'm going to choose Command C, Command V on my Mac. And then the one beneath, I'm going to type in description. Now I want these next to each other on the same row, left and right. So I'm going to highlight both of them, holding down shift, right click, group elements in a row container. Aha, looking good. Now we can name this to group tabs. And let's just close down this group so it fits height to the content of the text elements. So I'm going to remove them in height. Lovely stuff. Now back on the pop-up, I'm going to click on the pop-up. On the layout tab, I'm going to choose some gap spacing of 32. Okay, so now we're going to set up the state, and then after that, we're going to take a break. So in the past, I've said, try set states with a consistent approach, not just your naming conventions, but also where you set them. Instead of setting them on elements all around the page, making it difficult to work with other developers, rather set most of your states on the page element itself. But then in pop-ups, this is the only time I break this rule, because sometimes I like to copy and paste pop-ups between pages. I mean, the best approach for that would be making it a reusable element, but in any case, I do prefer states to be set in pop-ups themselves, okay? So let's do that first, then we'll create the workflows. I've got the property inspector for the pop-up job. I'm gonna click on the eye icon this time. And in the past, I've said that this is where we can see our custom states, but we can also add new ones with this method. So I'm gonna add a new custom state. I'm just gonna call this tab, and this will be type text. Okay, and check this out. Type in summary for the default. So that basically means when the pop-up shows for the first time, the summary tab will be selected. Fantastic. Now to run the workflows. So we still need a workflow for summary, even though it's the default, because once the description state has been set, well, we need a way to reset it back to the summary. Okay, so I'm going to add a workflow for summary. I'm going to filter the options by typing STA, set a state. I'm going to set it on the pop-up like discussed. And there it is there, tab. Okay. Now I've just typed summary, and please do the same. So that sets the state. Pretty basic. Back in the design tab, let's do the same for description. Add a workflow in the description. Filter by typing STA. Choose the pop-up, that's where the state is set. There is only one state on the pop-up, that's called tab. That would currently be summary, so now we have to overwrite it with the new value of description. Brilliant. And the last thing we need to do is we need some feedback for the user that these text elements have had their states set. So in the conditions tab, we're going to define another condition. The condition will read when the state is set, basically. So the state is at the pop-up. When the pop-up and custom states down the bottom, when its tab is, and now I'm going to type summary. It's case sensitive, so it needs to match whatever you typed in your workflow. Then I'm going to change the font color and the background color. Okay. I'm just going to inverse them. So the background color becomes dark and the font color becomes light. All right, I'm going to copy special, copy conditional expressions. I'm going to click on description, right click, paste special, paste conditional expressions. But we obviously have to change the value here. So instead of summary, I'm going to type description. Okay, I do want to actually test that that works before the break. Just one thing I noticed is that we need some border radius on this pop-up job. Currently set to 3, so I'm going to set it to 12, And I think while I'm at it, I'm just going to edit my style and set it on the style as well. 12. And now that I've done that, I can just reselect this. Okay, perfect. While we're here, this X icon, let's just start edit a workflow to hide the pop-up when the X is pressed. Start edit workflow. Going to type hide to hide an element. And let's just choose the pop-up. We'll continue to work on this because there are a few other things we need to do because we're going to have data in that pop-up. Okay, so click away so you can hide that pop-up. Then click on the new job button. Let's start edit a workflow on that or add a workflow. And now we're simply going to, I've typed in show to show an element, and we're going to show a pop-up, the pop-up job. Okay, let's preview the page. By the way, if you ever lose your avatars because you're not logged in, okay, so you have to go to the database and then run as Hannah from her user record. And if you ever don't see your logo, it's because your URL won't have the word or the company name in it as the slug, which is Orbit. So whenever we're working on these exercises, make sure that we have / company and then / company name. So let's click on new job, test out this pop-up. There we go. Click on description, states are being set, and click on the X icon. Fantastic. Okay, guys, good design work done. More practice with states. And in the next lesson, we're going to be adding all of the inputs. And then in the lesson after that, we're going to be looking at the workflow for data creation. And that's where it gets super exciting because you'll start to see a lot of jobs popping up and job variety to look at and more privacy rules to start configuring as well. I'll see you soon.